Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 105 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 180 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 181 and question 182. Question 181. You have an Azure subscription named Subscription 1. You deploy a Linux virtual machine named VM1 to Subscription 1. You need to monitor the matrices and logs of VM1. What should you use? Option A, Azure HD Insight. Azure HD Insight is a fully managed cloud service that helps in processing massive amount of data. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. Option C, the Azure Performance Diagnostic Extension. The Azure Performance Diagnostic Extension enables to collect monitoring data such as performance counters and event logs from Windows virtual machine. Therefore, it cannot be used with the Linux virtual machine. Option D, Azure Analysis Service. Azure Analysis Services is a fully managed platform as service that provides enterprise-grade data models in cloud. Therefore, it cannot be used to monitor matrices and logs for VM1. Now we are left with option B, Linux Diagnostic Extension or LAD. Let's go to learn.microsoft.com. We are on use the Linux Diagnostic Extension to monitor matrices and log page. We will scroll down. The Linux Diagnostic Extension helps you monitor the health of a Linux virtual machine on Microsoft Azure. It has following capabilities. So we can monitor matrices, we can monitor syslog, and we can monitor files. And Azure Table Storage is the required destination for all of those. Let's go back to question. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Let's move to next question. Question 182. You have an Azure subscription named Subscription 1. Subscription 1 contains a virtual machine named VM1. You install and configure a web server and DNS server on VM1. VM1 has the effective network security rule shown in the following exhibit. Let's understand how network security rules are configured for virtual machine on learn.microsoft.com. We are on network security groups page. You can use Azure network security groups to filter network traffic between Azure resources in an Azure virtual network. A network security group contains security rules that allow or deny inbound network traffic to or outbound network traffic from several types of Azure resources. Security rules. A network security group contains as many rules as desired. Within Azure subscription limits, each rule specifies following properties. Each rule have a name. It have a priority. And priority is between 100 and 4096. Rules are processed in priority order with the lower number processed before higher numbers because lower numbers have higher priority. That we have to keep in mind when we analyze the rules or create the rules. Source or destination can be any individual IP address, CIDR, service tag, or application group. Next property is protocol. Next is direction, whether the rule applies to inbound outbound traffic. Next is port range. You can specify an individual or range of ports. For example, you could specify port 80 or a range like 10,000 to 10,005. The last property is action. Either we can allow the traffic or deny the traffic. Let's go back to question. First question is about internet users. we need to select one of these answers. And we know that web server runs on port 80 and DNS server can be accessed on port 53. Therefore, we need to check inbound port rule that if we can access the port 80 or port 53 or not. On the lowest priority, everything is denied. Then Azure load balancer inbound is allowed. Then VNet inbound is allowed for virtual network access. And rule 1 permits inbound connection from port 50 to 500 from any source, that is allowed. Remote desktop connection is allowed. On the highest priority, rule 2 deny between port 50 to 60 from any source. Therefore, port 53 would not be accessible because rule 2 has the highest priority. And as per the rule 1, port 80 is accessible. Therefore, web server can be accessed, but DNS server role cannot be accessed. Option 2 is the correct answer. Can connect to only the web server on virtual machine 1. Now question 2. If you delete rule 2, internet users can connect. If we delete the rule 2, which means the port 53 will be allowed. And therefore, users will be able to connect to web server and DNS server on virtual machine. Therefore, the option 3 will be the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.